Welcome back to my channel. My name is Deanna and this is Daisy's Beauty. If you haven't already, make sure you go down and hit that subscribe button so you can become a part of my family here on YouTube. I love to have you. I post videos about 4 times a week, maybe more. And let's go ahead and get started. So today's video is going to be about your period. Your flower on your period. So I'm gonna come with it with the information for you because I always come through. First thing I want to talk about are pads. Wait, I have every single hygiene video that I've ever done linked down below, as well as the video for this makeup look in the description box. You guys know I've always used the Always pads and I highly suggested them in one of my previous hygiene videos, but my heart has turned. Maybe some of you don't know because you're new. I have a super sensitive skin and I mean all over my body. I have to take extra care of my flower. And by flower, I mean, you know. Be sensitive to the items that I'm putting in my area. Always pads have always worked for me and they have been doing me justice literally for years, you guys. Literally. Until I found these pads. It started irritating me a bit, maybe like about 2 or 3 months ago, and I was really having absolutely horrible, you guys. So I was on the hunt for a new pad. I didn't want to go to anything that was going to be highly scented or something that I really didn't trust. So I went ahead and I did some research. I don't wear tampons, but each of the pads that I have here, I'm going to give you a little bit of information about, and then I'm going to tell you why I like them and if I'll keep using them. The first set of pads that I have here are the Just brand. These pads are no dye, no fragrance, and no chlorine bleaching. So usually pads have lots of ingredients. Pads and tampons both have lots of ingredients that you don't even know. Lots of ingredients that could be toxic to some people and also cause allergic reaction. And I'm guessing that's what was happening to me all these years and even more now recently. I went to Walmart and later on that evening I went to Target. So first I went to Walmart and I discovered the Just brand. So I was literally on my phone the night before looking and Googling to see what brands, and the 3 brands that I have here are the best that I found so far that are going to be accessible to everyone, because I'm pretty sure there's a Walmart or a Target near you. These are 100% cotton on the top layer. There are no dyes, fragrance, or chlorine bleaching in these pads. You get 20 per pack, and if I'm not mistaken, they're around like $5. That's not bad. Honestly and truly, that's like the regular pricing, if not less, that she would get for any other pad. I like these, but they are not my favorite. These, I find that I have to change them more frequently. I do have to change them a bit more frequently than I do the other two that I have. But all in all, I do like them. If you don't have another option and you're not near a Target for the other 2 brands that I'm about to mention, I would highly suggest getting the Just brand. Like I said, they do have tampons as well. And you guys, they're super comfortable. You're not gonna get toxic shock from it or anything. And you don't have to worry about bleach or any other of those dyes and chemicals being inside your pad. 100% cotton top layer, and I think it's absolutely amazing. Next one is Elle. Now, Elle is also owned by another company. Elle was founded by a woman. I like these more than I like the Just because I feel like they're more gentle in my personal opinion, and I like that. You get 42 pads in this pack for like $7. They also have tampons, like I said, but these are no synthetic pesticides, dyes, or fragrances. They have a hyperallergenic cotton top sheet and they're cruelty free. I also like it because each time that you purchase these, you're giving back to young girls in different communities. And I really like that, that when I'm purchasing something that can be really self-conscious, that I'm helping someone else, that I know it could be something that they may be self-conscious about as well, and really helping them to empower them and just make them become better young women and women overall. So I really like that. So these are my, I believe, second favorite. So I do like the Just, but these are my second favorite pads. These are very comfortable. I don't have to change them as much as I do have to change the Just, and I don't get irritated with the Just sometimes if I like leave it on like a little bit over 2 hours, I'll start getting like irritated. But with these, like if I'm doing something at work or I just don't have time to go to the bathroom right then to just go take care of my lady parts and my lady bits, it gives me a little bit more lead. I can sleep through the night with these. I don't have to like wake up as frequent as I would during the daytime, and I really like that that's very comfortable for me personally. Like I said, these do have tampons as well. So this was a 42 for about $7. I think that's a great deal. It comes in a bag. I forgot to show you how they look. The just has very generic packaging. The L also looks the same way. Actually, when I like take them out and I set them out in my little thing in my closet here so they'll be accessible, I actually label them. So for L, I'll put an L on it, and for just, I'll either put a J or leave it blank so I'll know which one is which depending on like the demand of the day and when I want to use each one. Favorite pads out of them all. I actually thought that I wasn't even gonna like these and these weren't gonna be my favorite, but oh boy was I wrong. The Honey Pot Company pads are absolutely, undeniably amazing. Not even joking, guys. You guys know I get close to the camera when I get excited because I be real hype, and I'm real hype all the time about my lady parts and my flower when I find something that works right. Honey Pot Company is actually a black owned brand, and it's also woman owned. These are 20 pads in this package here, and they're herbally infused, you can see, with mint, lavender, and aloe. Chlorine free, pesticide free, and fragrance free. They are completely plant based feminine care. Feminine wash, they have tampons, they have anything that you can think of. Balms, like they have everything. You can go on their website and you can also find them in Target. L you can find in Target, and just you can find in Walmart. I love these, you guys. I thought I wasn't going to like it. Now, I must admit, when you put it on, you're gonna be a little shocked, because that mint is gonna literally start cooling down your flower. Candace said hi, guys. But it is. I got this level, it's 4, and I got the second level. You guys, it's...
Being herbally infused and having fragrance is two different things. Fragrance is a chemical, and being herbally infused is plant-based.
Well, so good. When I tell you, when you put these on, you know how sometimes as a woman or a young lady, you'll be able to kind of smell the period smell sometimes? Like, I know it all happens to all of us. No need to be shy over here. You can kind of smell it sometimes, and you don't really want that. As with these, you're not smelling a thing, baby. Every time you go to the bathroom, every time you make a movement, you're smelling whatever it is infused with, which is lavender, mint, and aloe. Mommy. It literally is a very soothing, it is cooling, and the lavender is calming. Like, your area feels very, very relaxed, you guys. And this is why these are my favorite. I will continue to and forever buy these. Now, after I'm finished with those, I don't know if I'll repurchase those, just because I don't need three different sets of pads. I'll be just fine with like one or two. So I think I'll keep repurchasing the L and the Honey Pot, because the Honey Pot is like, for 20, I believe it's like $7 or $8, somewhere around there. Like I said, they do have other products. They have higher absorbency of each pad. They have tampons, you guys, you name it, they have it. So I really, 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 really love these pads. Enough about this. They smell so good, you guys. And it's literally so cooling. And I literally agree with all the claims. On the bottom, it shows you all the claims. The claims are comfortable, soft, breathable, pesticide-free, and chlorine-free. So it's gynecologist tested, and it's pesticide-free, chlorine-free. It is very comfortable, soft, and breathable. So I agree with all the claims, and I love them. So enough about pads, you guys. I just wanted to share with you guys a couple of things.
Hi, guys. So I went to film it. It was a hand.
He said you can use that to wash your hair. We'll talk about that in another video.
Bye.
We're gonna get into some other hygiene tips that I think would be perfect for you to know that you probably don't know when you're on your cycle. For one, you guys know I rave about the Dr. Bronner's 18-in-1 Pure Castile Peppermint Soap. I feel absolutely so fresh when I'm using this. I highly suggest, not only when you're on your cycle, I suggest that you use this every single day, and it does have that minty coolie feeling. Now if that's not something that you like, then I do have another alternative for you. Second soap, you guys know I go hard for Rim. Now I'm using the Shea Butter and Vanilla Body Wash by Rim here. This is 100% vegan brand. So anything that you buy from this brand, whether it's shampoo, conditioner, soap, anything period, is vegan. What it looks like here, you can get this from, to my knowledge, Walmart, Dollar General, and maybe Target and TJ Maxx and their website. Those are all the places that I've seen this brand here. I have many different fragrances. I honestly don't suggest that you put this in your area, although it's vegan, because it does have a light fragrance. The ones that I personally have and the ones that I've tried, I don't suggest putting that in your flower region, because I just don't think it would turn out great for you. If you want to wash with something, don't ever put anything inside your flower bed. Don't ever do that. Don't ever put anything inside your flower bed. But what you can do is wash the outside and clean up the outside of the flower bed so it could be nice, neat, and smelling good. You can wash the remainder of your body with this though. Let's get into the maintenance of your area. Now I have two products here that you can pick up from the Dollar Tree. The maintenance of your flower bed, I suggest that you either completely clear all the hair off, or you keep it trimmed very, very low. And to keep that maintenance up, I have two products here that I think would work absolutely amazing. I have coconut oil. It is 100% pure refined coconut oil. I did get this from the Dollar Tree. It is on the cooking aisle, and it works absolutely amazing. The next thing I have are razors. Now I already opened it and used it because I wanted to test it out and give you guys a clear, like, kind of review of how I think it feels and how I think it would work for you and if it's actually good or not. So three razors actually come in this pack for $1 from the Dollar Tree. It is razors with 5 blades. Now you guys know that I rant and I rave about using razors with more than 1 or 2 or 3 blades, preferably. It works good. I used this razor last night, and you guys, I think it works fabulously. It got it off quick. I didn't get any cuts, and I used it with the coconut oil. So I literally shaved with the coconut oil and I used the razor and really like it. Now the preference of if you're gonna have little hair or no hair is totally up to you. It's what you want to do. But prior to your period coming on, your cycle coming on, you shouldn't, first you need to know when your cycle is coming on. So whether you need to put it in your phone every time that it comes on, or about the time that it comes on, the week it's gonna come on, or whether you have a tracker in your phone or anything like that, you need to know so that you can gather all these products that I'm explaining to you today, and so that you can groom prior to it coming on. All of what's coming out is gonna get caught up in it, it's gonna create odor, you're gonna feel even more disgusting, and it's just not gonna feel good at all. So make sure you get these two products from the Dollar Tree. Again, it was the 5-blade razors, 3 comes in a pack for $1, in the coconut oil. This is either 59 cents or $1 right now at Dollar Tree, so you're not spending a lot of money to keep everything groomed and maintained down there. And coconut oil is 100% natural, so you're not using anything that's too much. It's not going to irritate you in your area or anything like that. Now that you've groomed, you know what pads you're going to use, you're using 100% cotton, organic, plant-based, whatever type of pads or tampons. Talk about some more hygiene just to keep you smelling fresh and feeling fresh throughout your time of the month. Now, all right, so we've gotten that out the way. We know what we're washing with, what type of sanitary napkins that we're going to be using. We know what we're keeping it groomed with. We know how we're keeping it groomed. We know how we're keeping our other two areas groomed. Now we need to know how to sort of moisturize our skin. During that time of the month, I suggest that you use Vaseline. It is more of a healing aid. So that means, say you're not using any of the items that I mentioned as far as sanitary napkins or pads, whatever you'd like to call it, and you get a little irritated. You put Vaseline on the chafing or the irritation, you put your pad on, and you go about your day. It's gonna really help you. After you tidy your area up and you do your maintenance, you can put Vaseline all over the top layer of your area. So if this is your area, you can put Vaseline here once you've groomed, or just on your bikini line if you're just planning on doing your bikini line, so that it can be nice and smooth. But I highly suggest Vaseline for over your entire body. I think it's very healing and it's very soothing as well. You can also use the coconut oil that you have that you're using for your shaving as far as a moisturizer as well. So between Vaseline and coconut oil, you should honestly be good to go. One more thing with you guys, and I think it's very important. I don't see a lot of people talking about it when they put in their hygiene videos, but I'm gonna talk about a vitamin that I think you guys should be taking, not only during your time of the month, but also every other day. These are probiotics. Now, I got mine from like Walgreens, I believe, but basically a probiotic just is like a friendly bacteria to help your digestive system and to help your flower bed stay healthy. Like, it is good overall for your entire body, and I honestly think that this is something that everybody should incorporate into their hygiene overall, but especially during that time of the month, so that you can create healthy bacteria down there. This would make a major difference in a lot of people's lives that they don't even know. You can pair this with some cranberry juice, because cranberry juice, 100% cranberry juice, not cocktail, is a very, very good for you as well. You can also drink pineapple juice, and always, always, always drink plenty of water. This is not just during your time of the month, but preparing up to it, because what you do throughout the entire month is going to ultimately determine like cramps, odor, everything like that. So make sure you're just putting good things into your body, so when something's coming out, it's also maybe not gonna feel the best, but it's not gonna have like a horrible odor or anything like that. So here's another up close look at it. It's Nature's Bounty. As far as like fragrances for your body, I have two mists here that I think that you can use periodically throughout the day. You can keep it in your purse or your car or something like that, just to keep handy, so when you're getting ready to go somewhere or around a lot of people, you can just spritz yourself really fast. Now during the day, if you'd like, you could wear perfumes, but for now I think I'm just gonna share a few mists with you guys that I think are good to use. These are friendly and affordable, like affordable friendly, so because you can always get them on sale. They are from Bath and Body Works. Beautii Island Dream here. And I have Oahu Coconut Sunset. Both of these smell really good. To me, this one is a bit more coconutty. More coconut than the Tahiti Dream. Now, they both smell like really good and kind of sweet, but not too much. So I think it would be good fragrances to pair and to just spritz when you want a burst of fragrance. I don't suggest that you're putting like heavy fragrances directly on your body. The deodorant that I use is not heavily fragranced. Only pretty much fragrance as far as that I would put on my body is this. But honestly, you guys, during my time of the month, I don't put anything fragrancy on my body, really. Honestly, I don't, besides maybe like a mist or something that I'm like spraying indirectly on my body. I honestly use the 18-in-1 Dr. Bronner soap, but I did want to give a different option for some people who do like smelling good, or you know, give them an extra boost during that time. Guys, this is the end of the video. This is all the tips that I have for you. If you have any more questions or concerns for me, don't be afraid to put it in the comment section down below. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe, you guys. I'd love to have you a part of my family here. I love talking to you guys, making content for you guys. So comment down below any other questions that you have. I'll be sure to answer each and every one of them. You guys know I will. I try to comment back to each of you guys every time that I read a comment that you guys leave me. Bring people to my channel. Tell people about my channel. If you have any video ideas or requests that you want me to do, you can also comment that down below in the comment section. Now you guys know I'm not gonna forget. Don't forget to give someone your smile today. I love you guys. Make sure you're spreading happiness and spreading all those smiles. As always, I'm gonna give you guys my smile. You keep passing your smile along, and I'll see you in the next video. Again, I'm gonna have all my other hygiene videos, if you haven't seen them, down below in the description box, as well as this beautiful makeup look that I did for this video in the description box down below as well. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. And if the makeup look is not up when it does go up, I'll put it down in the description box. So get caught up in all my other videos. And if this goes up first or the makeup video goes up first, they'll both be in each other's description box either way. Anyway, I'm gonna stop rambling. Love you guys. Two pieces. And I'll see you next time.